what the Most High has revealed to us about Shiloh coming and his restored appointed times that are contained in his 42 restored 30-day months is irrefutable proof that he has declared the day and the year of his vengeance, the vengeance of his temple. The only way that any of you can refute this declaration is to refute the testimony of his word. His word tells us that the Ark of His covenant and that which is contained in its sides, including His song that He gave to us through His servant Moses, that is also on the scrolls that are in this Ark, are going to be a witness against the scattered descendants of Israel at the time of the end. Yahweh spoke this through His servant Moses to our ancestors before He died. This is recorded in Deuteronomy chapter 31. Yahweh said to Moses, "Behold, you will sleep with your fathers, and this people will rise up, and they will go a-whoring after the Elohims of the strangers of the land," other images of who he is. "And they will go to be among them, and they will forsake me," or they will forsake the true image of who he is, "and they will break my covenant, which I have made with them." I will show you in a bit how this covenant is his covenant to gather those who will be gathered unto him. Verse 17, "Then my anger will be kindled against them in that day, and I will forsake them, and I will hide my face from them, and they will be devoured. And many evils and troubles will befall them, so that they will say in that day, 'Have not these evils come upon us because Elohim is not with us?' Indeed, he will not be with you. I will surely hide my face in that day," he says, "because of all of the evil which they have done, and that which they have turned to other Elohims, turned to false images of who he is. Therefore, record this song for you and teach it to the children of Israel and put it in their mouths so that this song will be a witness from me against the children of Israel." This song is discussed in other videos that are on this site. I'll put the link to one of them called "The Song That No One Would Know Except for the 144,000 in the video description box below. Moses went on to tell the Levites that bore the Ark of the Most High's covenant the following instructions. Deuteronomy 31, "Take this scroll of the Torah and put it inside of the Ark of Yahweh Elohim's covenant to be there as a witness against you." We are told in other scriptures that all that is inside of the Ark is Yahweh's witness or his testimony or his witness against the descendants of Israel. Verse 27, "Because I know your rebellion and your stiff necks, behold, you have been rebellious against Yahweh while I am still alive with you this day. How much more so will you be after my death? How much more so would you continue to rebel against the Most High because he has held back unleashing his hot indignation upon you? Nearly all of the scattered descendants of Israel have taken advantage of his loving kindness and the blessing promises that he handed down to you because you are the descendants of Abraham and you have lived with no fear of not being found in his favor." The following is one of the places that he calls this ark that dwells in his tent of appointed times the ark of his testimony. In Exodus chapter 40, verse 1, "And Yahweh spoke to Moses, saying, 'On the first day of the first month you shall set up the dwelling place of the tent of the appointed times, and you shall put the ark of his testimony, or the ark of his witness, there, and cover the ark with a veil.'" The King James translators translated verse 2 to say "the tabernacle of the tent of the congregation." Their rebellious, uncircumcised hearts are exposed in translations like this. Their hypocrisy was off the charts. When the Hebrew word for dwelling place is not present in the verses talking about the tent of his appointed times, they call the Hebrew word for tent the tabernacle. They knew what these words meant, and so can any of the rest of you by simply looking them up in a concordance. They also knew the Hebrew word for congregation was a different word when they translated this tent as the tabernacle of the congregation. They knew that this Hebrew word moed or moedim means appointed times. There are places in the same verse and in back-to-back verses that both of these two completely different Hebrew words are used, where they translated them correctly. They especially desired to conceal the word for appointed times whenever it suited their rebellious, uncircumcised hearts to do so. Examples of this are discussed in other videos. But those of you who fell prey to their concealing these things are still without excuse. The Most High allowed for these mistranslations. He did so in order to test and prove our resolve to be found in his favor and to become as he is. This is why he put Satan and the demons here. You are without excuse because there is enough that he did not let them conceal that you could have hearkened to so that he would have delivered you out of the captivity. He gave us his word in order to call us to him through it. We have to come to his call. The reason why many are called but few are chosen is because few continue coming to his call. Few chose to hearken to that which is in his word that he made readily available to us that is not concealed. For those of you who have watched the last couple of videos, there are not words that can describe your obstinate, stiff-necked hearts if you refuse to acknowledge the gold that is contained in the Most High's calling, the tent that houses his Ark of his covenant, the tent of his appointed times. In lieu of his restored 30-day months, it is absolutely incredible that he named the day of the second Exodus the day of his appointed times. It is awesome that he has manifested his 42 restored 30-day months to us in a way that the only way that we can deny this restoration is to deny what his word testifies to. The Most High dwells with those who hearken to his word and hedge about his appointed times. His appointed times is the dwelling place of his covenant. He housed the Ark of his covenant in a tent during the first Exodus for a reason. He set up his restoration of his 30 day months and restored times of his appointed times through doing so. In Hosea chapter 12, I, Yahweh Elohim, brought you out from the land of Egypt. Yet again, I will make you to dwell in tents in the day of my appointed time. I have spoken through my prophets, and I will multiply my revelations through similitudes through the hand of my prophets. If you cannot see this connection between the day of this second Exodus being called the day of his appointed time and the dwelling place of his Ark of his covenant being called the tent of his appointed times, you are either ridiculously obstinate and stiff-necked, or you are totally blinded by the Most High. The Hebrew word for Ark comes from a word that means to gather. How this ties in with Shiloh and the Promised Land is awesome. In Genesis 49, we're told, a shepherd's rod will not be removed from Judah. The graven decrees will be between Judah's feet until Shiloh comes, and Yahweh's people will be gathered. It is awesome that the Most High pitched the dwelling place of his covenant to gather his people at Shiloh after they crossed over the Jordan River and entered into the Promised Land. The two tiers of this passage concerning the first fruits and those of you who the Most High is going to deliver into the millennium are discussed in the last video called Until Shiloh Comes. Shiloh comes from a word that means to be safe. At the end of the last video, I said he, referring to the Most High, has reared up his safe house of his appointed times. I did not know that Shiloh came from a word that means to be safe when I spoke this. He led me to look up what it means after I said this. I spoke this in reference to him pitching his tent of his appointed times by restoring his appointed times through his servant. He has caused his servant, through whom he has restored his appointed times, to dwell in tents at the time of the second Exodus that is at hand. In doing so, the Most High has sent Shiloh, fleeing from touching the dead and fleeing to the mountains and returning to him through that which he has restored, including his restored appointed times, is his place of safety. Yahweh instructing his servant Moses to set up the dwelling place of his covenant to gather those who would gather unto him through his appointed times and through the rest of his Torah that's inside of the ark on the first day of the first month is also very significant to the here and the now. His end time prophecy that he gave to us through his servant Ezekiel tells us that his sanctuary is to begin to be cleansed on this day. On this past first day of his first month, on his restored calendar, the Most High wove a tier of this into his end time timeline that began the 40-year period that we are now in. The first day of the first month is also the day that his servant Noah removed the covering off of the ark. This first day of the first month this year on Yahweh's restored calendar was 200 days from the last day of his Feast of Temporary Dwellings this year. Some of the significance of these 200 days is discussed in other videos, and one of them is a river of blood video. The first day of the first month next year will also be 200 days from the last day of this feast next year. And the last day of this feast next year is the beginning of the great and the fearful day of Yahweh's wrath. These 200 days and the 200 miles of the Jordan River that is discussed in the River of Blood video tie the great and the fearful day of his wrath in with the need for each of you to do what is required of you to cause the Most High to turn your baptism waters into his only begotten Son's shed blood, so that you will not be a recipient of this day? That which is required of you is for you to flee from touching the dead and flee to the mountains and return to the Most High through that which he's restored, including his restored appointed times, so that he and his only begotten Son will dwell with you and you with them. I read to you earlier in Exodus chapter 40, where his word also calls the covenant of his gathering his people that are gathered unto him through his appointed times the ark of his testimony, or the ark of his witness. In lieu of this, this ark could also be called the gathering of his two witnesses, of those of you who will gather unto that which they have testified to. This ark was covered. One of the Most High's five commandments that he gave to us in his Ezekiel chapter 24 sign is for you to cover your heads at this time as an outward sign of coming under his covering. This is to be a sign that you have agreed to his terms to do that which will cause him to turn your baptism waters into his Son's shed blood, so that you can come under the covering of his only begotten Son's shed blood. Like I said, his terms are for you to flee from the captivity. Flee to the dwelling place of the Ark of his covenant that is housed in the tent of his appointed times. Flee to the dwelling place of his covenant to gather his people that is housed in the tent of his appointed times. Thus saith the testimony of Yahweh Elohim's word.